चैरिटी फ्रॉम बलि महाराज। There are like four sections. First section, Baman Dev is praising Bali Maharaj and his dynasty. Okay. Second chapter describes this. 19th chapter describes how Lord Baman Dev asked for 3 paces of land in charity. How Bali Maharaj agreed to his proposal and how Shukracharya forbade Bali Maharaj to fulfill Lord Vamadeva's request. When Bali Maharaj, thinking Vamadeva to be the son of Brahmana, told him to ask for anything he liked, Lord Vamadeva praised Hiranyakashipu and Hiranyaksha for their heroic activities. And after thus praising the family in which Bali Maharaj had been born, he begged the king for 3 paces of land. Bali Maharaj agreed to give this land in charity since this was very insignificant. But Shukracharya who could understand that Vaman Dev was Vishnu, the friends of the demigods, forbade Bali Maharaj to give this land. Shukracharya advised Bali Maharaj to withdraw his promise. He explained that in subduing others, in joking, responding to danger, in acting for the welfare of others, and so on, one could refuse to fulfill one's promise and thus would be no fault. By this philosophy, Shukracharya tried to dissuade Bali Maharaj from giving land to Lord Vamadeva. Text 1. Sri Shuka Vacha Iti Vairocha Nirvakyam Dharma Yuktam Sasunurtam Nishamya Bhagavan Prita Pratinandetam Apravi Sri Shuka Vacha Sri Shuka Sakta Kiti Das Vairocha Ne the son of Virochan Bhakyam, the words Dharma Yuktam in terms of religious principles, Sahir, Nirtam, Perikriti, Nishamya, Bhagavan, the person recorded Vita completely clear. Pratinandya, congratulating him, Idam, the following word Abravi said. Shuddha Goswami continued, when the Supreme Personality Godhead Vamadeva heard Bali Maharaj speaking in this pleasing way, he was very satisfied, for Bali Maharaj had spoken in terms of religious principles. Thus, the Lord began to praise him. Sri Bhagavan Vacha Vachas Tavaita Chanadeva Sunyatam Kulo Chitam Dharma Yutam Yashaskaram Yasya Pramanam Bhagava Samparaye Pita Mahakula Vridha Prashantaha. Sri Bhagavan Vacha, the Supreme Personality of God, had said, Vacha, words, Tava, Yur, Etat, this kind of Jana Deva, O King of the people, Sunirtam, very truthful, Uchitam, by exactly 50 Kudanis, Dharma Yutam, in accord with the principle of religion, Yashaha, Karam, fit for spreading your reputation, Yasya, of whom, Pramanam, the evidence, Bhagava, the Brahmanas of the Tribu dynasty, Samparaye in the next world, Peet Maha, your grandfather, Kula Vritta, the oldest in the family, Prashanta, very peaceful, Prahlad Maharaj. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, O King, you are indeed exalted. Because, now Vamadeva is saying, O King, you are indeed exalted because your present advisors are the Brahmanas, who are the descendants of Bhagu. And because your instructor for your future life is your grandfather, the peaceful and venerable Prahlad Maharaj, you are so glorious. At present, you are taking guidance from Brahmanas. So anyway, you are glorious. Okay, because a king, a good king, always takes guidance from the Brahmins and then he rules. And your grandfather is there, Prahlad Maharaj. Your statements are very true and they completely agree with religious etiquette. They are in keeping with the behavior of your family. And they enhance your reputation. Okay. Prahlad Maharaj is a vivid example of a pure devotee. Someone might argue that since Prahlad Maharaj, even though very old, was attached to his family and specifically to his grandson Bali Maharaj. Okay, Prahlad Maharaj, even though very old, was attached to his family and specifically to his grandson Bali Maharaj. How could he be an ideal example? Therefore, this verse uses the word prashantaha. A devotee is always sober. He is never disturbed by any condition. Even if a devotee remains in the life, and does not renounce material possessions, he should still be understood to be prasanta, sober, because of his pure devotion to the Lord. He has not renounced, no problem, but his devotion is so pure that he is still considered as sober and prasanta. Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu therefore said, very nice, very important. Kiva vipra kiva nyasi, sutre kena nae, yeni krishna tattva, tattuveta se guru hai. Whether one is a brahman, a sannyasi, or a sudra, regardless of what he is, doesn't matter whether he is a brahman, kshatriya, sannyasi, or sudra, whoever he may, if he knows the science of Krishna, yehi krishna tattveta, if he knows the science of Krishna, he can become a spiritual master, say guru. He is guru because he knows Krishna, right? So who cares whether he took birth in a sudra family? Nobody cares about it. What we are caring, what we are looking for, that he knows Krishna tattva, he knows science of Krishna, he will teach me, so I am accepting him as my guru. Okay, so anyone completely aware of the science of Krishna, regardless of his status in life, is a guru. Thus Prahlad Maharaj is a guru in all circumstances. Here his lordship Vamandev also teaches sannyasis and brahmacharis that one should not ask more than necessary. He wanted only 3 paces of land, although Vali Maharaj wanted to give him anything he wanted. Na heti asmin kule kashchinna sattva kripana, na heti asmin kule kashchinna sattva kripana pumana pratyakhyata pratishrutta yo vadata dujataye. Na not he did asmin this kule in the dynasty or family kashchit anything sattva poor minded. Krapana, miser, kuman, any person, pratya, kyata, refuted, pratishrutya, after promising to give yahava, either adata, not being titled, dijitae, dijatae, unto the Brahman. I know, Vamandev is saying, I know that even until now, no one taking birth in your family has been poor minded or miser. No one has refused to give charity to Brahmins, nor after promising charity has anyone failed to fulfill promise. Vamandev is glorifying in this way the dynasty of Vali Maharaj. Na santi tipe yunicharthi narthita parang mukhaye tvamanisvinu nirpa yushmat kule yaddashasam lena prahlada utthati utho yatho dukhake. Na not santi there are tirthe in holy places where charity tipe the battlefield cha also arjuna vaya brahmana kshatriya arjita who have been asked pranamukha who refuse their prayers, yes, such person too indeed. Aman Prinaha, such low-minded, low great kings, Nirbahu King Palima Yushmukule, Neodanasi, yet they are in Yasasa Amalena by impeccable reputation, Prarada Pratna Udubhati arises yata as Udupaha the moon ke in the sky. O King Bali, never in your dynasty has the low-minded king been born who, upon being requested, has refused charity to Brahmins in holy places or a fight to Kshatriya on the battlefield. Nobody was there in your dynasty. All are very charitable to Brahmanas and very much they will never say no to charity, Brahman, and no to fight in the battlefield to Kshatriya. They will never say no. And your dynasty is even more glorious due to the presence of Prahlad Maharaj, who is like the beautiful moon in the sky. The symptoms of a Kshatriya are given in Bhagavad Gita. One of the qualifications is the willingness to give charity dana. A Kshatriya does not refuse to give charity when requested by a Brahmin, nor can he refuse to fight another Kshatriya. A king who does refuse is called low-minded. In the dynasty of Bali Maharaj, there were no such low-minded kings. Okay. Okay, so text 5, 6, 7. Okay, so 5 onwards we will speak tomorrow. Already is time. this glorification of Bali Maharaj dynasty will go till chapter 5, shloka 15 first. Now he will, 5th, 6th, he will speak about Hiranyaksha, then Hiranyakashipu, and then Vamandev will praise Virochan, and then Bali Maharaj. All the king in the dynasty of Bali Maharaj, Vamandev will praise. So that we will discuss tomorrow. Hare Krishna, thank you so much. Shri Prabhupada ki jai. If you have any question, comment, you can ask. Hare Krishna. Okay, no question. Okay, thank you. Hare Krishna. Shri Prabhupada ki jai. Granth Rashtra Bhagavatam ki jai. Anand Koti Vaishnava.